Thank you. Okay, so I hope you all enjoyed your lunch, and I wanted to just take a moment to introduce our new speaker. Tisha Clemens she's dual citizen, it seems to me, of many different cultures, but she is was raised in Spain by her parents are Spanish and Swedish. She went to Swedish school in Spain, and she's very, very talented in the healing arts. From a very young age, she started to study and to integrate into her life, because of her mother, all these different tools for nutrition. And she studied at BYU in Utah, and she has been with doTERRA for 2 years, building the business since January. But she's going to be speaking to us today about lifelong vitality. So if you'll just put your hands together and welcome our Tisha Clemens to the stage.
I have actually dual career, so to say. Dualization has been for 17 years as a freelancer, so I consider myself a digital nomad. I have lived in several countries and always work from home, so I'm very fond of not having a boss. And then the health part, as Sharon said, stated, I have been studying it since I was a child, and actually my childhood dream was to be médico pastelero, I used to say. I wanted to heal people with cakes. So that developed into studying nutrition in different ways. Got a couple degrees on that. And this is with my mom, who went to convention this year. And we work together. We have a joint account, my mom, my husband, and me. So there's a trio of us. And I am very, very fond of how you can keep your health in the best way. So, oils are awesome. I think everybody agrees on that, but oils are not everything. You still need to eat, sleep, exercise. And this, you probably have seen, it's a doTERRA pyramid. And I think it's very interesting to compare it with what many governments have said about the food pyramid. So you have to have most in the bottom side. The bottom part is eating right is the basis for everything that you do in life. And then, of course, exercise, sleeping and resting, reducing the toxic load in our lives, less chemistry, less synthetic stuff. Informed self-care up here is where the oils would come in, helping your health when you have an issue. And on the top, I think medical care is great. We live in the 21st century. So we do need to take advantage of that and go and get an x-ray, get a diagnosis, but then have an open mind. Okay, now that I know what is wrong with me, let's find out why it happened and what we can do about that. And I have strongly felt that what we eat is super, super important. But what happens with what we eat? In my study of integrative nutrition, they stated that every person is different, every body is different. Some people feel great as vegetarians, others prefer paleo, macrobiotic, traditional Mediterranean diet. There's tons of ways to eat. But something that everybody needs is actually vegetables. And well, fruits are a bit in dispute, but vegetables, green vegetables, everybody needs, and lots of them. And when I speak to people, almost everybody agrees we don't eat good enough. Not because we don't know that you have to eat good, but then you just don't have time. I actually was going to start my timer to know where I am. Everybody knows we have to eat good and proper food and take the time to eat quietly and relaxed, but we don't have time to do that. And even if we did eat right, say you're a vegan, you have lots of greens every single day, our body has much more need than the food that you can actually make yourself eat. And there's a lot of reasons for that. So I'll be covering a few of why supplements actually make sense, actually for anyone. This is what I intend to show you, and then why LLB rather than anything else. Fact is, here I have a couple slides, you may just glance at the top right. This one is a study from the UK, 1936 levels of nutrients versus 1987. And up here you have from the States, 1950 versus 2001. And the sad fact is that most nutrients have been depleted. So almost everywhere in the world, and the levels are a bit different depending on where you have grown, as you know from our oils, and the soil where things grow is very different. But levels have diminished a lot, and there's lots of information about this. You can go and look up statistics. But magnesium has been depleted. Calcium is not present in the vegetables the way it was, and every other nutrient as well. So even if we could eat fantastically well today, and even growing our own gardens, it's not going to be as good as it was before. And this quote is from 1936. Already then, they were saying that it's an alarming fact that the food doesn't contain enough of certain needed minerals, no matter how good we eat, no matter how we eat. So this was happening in 1936, and just guess now, our ancestors 100 years ago were getting much better nutrition just by food. So food alone doesn't help. On top of that, we have free radicals. Has anybody heard about those? The free radicals, it's very popular. We have some that come from outside. Yes, smoking is really bad, sun, pollution, unhealthy food, chlorine in the water, synthetic medicine, and all the stuff they put in our food as well. All of this produces free radicals in our bodies, but our bodies themselves, just by breathing, just by living, we are producing free radicals also. Stress makes you producing more free radicals. Doing exercise, and that's great, but then you're using more oxygen and you're oxidizing, so you need to counteract that. And inflammation, and we have seen, and if you've studied anything about the aromatherapy technique, we emphasize most people have an ongoing degree of chronic inflammation. And that does a lot of things. What a free radical is doing is a chain reaction. Those are molecules that are very, very unstable, and they need an extra electron to survive. So they grab the electron from all the other, we're talking about atoms in our body, and destabilize them and make them sick. And the chain reaction goes one to the other to the other. So every time we're exposed to free radicals, it's causing a chain reaction in our body that is giving you, well, this is the symptoms that you get from oxidative stress in pretty much all of your body. You get all sorts of diseases that are affected by oxidative stress. So the environment we live in is really inducing to disease. And perhaps I'm biased because in my family we work in natural health. My mother she left to work as an architect back in 93 in order to teach natural health. And we keep seeing people who are sick. Other people don't have that experience, but it seems to me that everybody has something going on in their lives. So what antioxidants do is that they are molecules that have electrons to spare. They come and counteract these chain reactions. I thought these pictures were kind of fun to give you a nice idea. Because this is what happens in your body when you're having this this chain reaction. What happens in your apple happens in your cells. Does anybody know the trick to prevent an apple from going brown?
Lemon
juice. And why? It does have lemon juice. Antioxidants. Yeah, it has vitamin C, among other things. And that helps the apple from going brown. So the food that we eat contains antioxidants. And what kind of food is that? Well, anything that has vitamin C is antioxidant. And vitamin E, there's a number of vitamins that help in the process. Then fresh greens, raw food, and that is green and vegetables and so. Spices, essential oils, obviously, have a lot of antioxidants. Superfoods, different sorts, goji berries, you know, this kind of thing, algae. And then supplements that are including this kind of food in the supplements, provided the supplement is suitable, as we'll get to. So spices that have a lot of antioxidants. You know some of these. We have oil, cinnamon, clove, fennel, oregano, cumin, garlic is not oil, ginger, black pepper. We have a lot of oils that are coming from these spices that are rich in antioxidants as well. So why do we need supplements? This quote I heard from Sweden, and I thought, yeah, that's totally true. Depending on what kind of supplement you're getting, the problem is that lots of supplements have synthetic versions, and as we know from the oils, the synthetic versions don't interact with your body, are not going to give you good results. If there are like super high doses, sometimes you see supplements and they have like 500% of this nutrient, 1000% of vitamin A. That's crazy, because it could be really, really bad for you, and they're completely messed up. So those nutrients that you can expel through urine, good for you, because at least they won't be toxic. And you know, some people get a lot of expensive urine, and you're not going to have a result in your health that is worthwhile. So when people go say, oh yeah, I've read that vitamin C is awesome, so I'll go buy some vitamin C. And then some vitamin E, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. I'm kind of going to do a little cocktail hell here with the alphabet. And yeah, you might think you know chemistry, but if you ever heard Dr. Hill or one of the scientists of doTERRA, you say like, I don't know anything about chemistry, these guys know a lot more than me, and that is very complex. So getting it right is very complicated, and it could go very wrong, because balance is super important. And there got a few examples. Calcium has to be in a proportion with magnesium, so that the calcium that you absorb and the magnesium that you absorb are in a 2-to-1 proportion. You got to take folic acid and vitamin B12 in order to absorb iron, vitamin C, and D. There's a lot of things going on there. So if you just do it yourself, you're not getting it right. The liposoluble vitamins are those who are not dissolved in water, like the oils, you know? Oils dissolve in oils because they're liposoluble. Well, the liposoluble vitamins, you're not getting them out in your pee. Vitamin A is one of them. You get too high levels, you do get sick. And they estimated, at convention they mentioned, if you just pick an assorted amount of stuff, bottle by bottle, you're getting up at like $300 a month, just doing it by yourself. So doTERRA has done a very, very wise approach. Mega doses are not good. You need the dose that you need, just enough for your body. And they decided to design that ideal supplement, even though it might be cost prohibitive, because it had to be really, really good so that we could absorb it, with good balance and bioavailable. This is actually key, because if you're getting some sources of the nutrients that are not bioavailable, mineral sources, synthetic sources, obviously, you know, just not getting them in your body. And not synthetic, obviously. So this, as we always say, doTERRA is not curing diseases, but the lifestyle choices that you make can prevent disease. Your doctor is treating your symptoms and fixing that it's broken, but it's your body who's doing the healing. And the oils and doTERRA and all of us are here to support your body in doing the healing process. So this is what doTERRA came up with. And I think it's very exciting, and I've had a chance to really plunge in the last couple months on these. So glycoprotein matrix is a form that many of the nutrients in this product is. That's what's going to make that your body can absorb them better. The nutrients are like embedded in a protein, so to say, so your body can absorb them. And shorter time, so. So what doTERRA has done is put the nutrients packed in a protein and giving you some enzymes to make sure you can digest the proteins, both in the supplement and in the food you're eating, plus giving you lots of minerals. And yeah, call me a geek, but I thought it was really cool to plunge into the label and look at so many of the nutrients are, you know, glycoprotein matrix, chelated iron, that's super important to get it actually absorbed. And yeah, here you have more chelates. Then you have some whole food blends Because as we know, if the stuff comes straight from nature, straight from the plant, you are going to be able to absorb it so much better. Enzyme blend, then Dr. Hill says you should be taking the enzyme supplement as well, but you do have a little bit of enzymes in the supplement. And tummy tamer blend by doTERRA, so you can think of the hydrocin oil, but 30 milligrams, just a little bit to make sure that you can absorb and really benefit from this. And the levels are high, and something interesting to notice is that the daily recommended daily value is what the amounts that have been figured that you need in order not to get sick. But in order to have optimum health, the levels might be a little higher, but still no crazy levels here, as you can see. And then some of them, it has been a bit more conservative because we do get them in food. Yes. So, and you don't have any of the bad stuff in it. So I think that's super important also to be aware of. Then inflammation, as he was mentioning before, is really bad. Inflammation is a good thing for the body if you get like you bang your finger and inflammation will give more blood into the area to help heal. But if you have a chronic inflammation throughout your body, you're gonna be suffering from disease and pain and lots of other issues. And the essential fatty acids are gonna help with that because omega-6 will cause more inflammation in your body. Omega-3 is anti-inflammatory. And the thing here is that we need this ratio, equal parts in our diet in order to have a proper balance. Omega-6 is in all the food that we usually like to eat, but it's not good for us. So normal diets have this balance. And most people have an ongoing chronic inflammation that is asymptomatic until you get something coming up that catches your attention. So the doTERRA products are heavy on omega-3, and the omega supplement, you have it in both normal and vegan, but it's both omega-3s, antioxidant, and essential oils, which are doing the antioxidant work so that the supplement doesn't oxidize. I think that's really cool. This is the vegan version for people who don't want to eat fish. Also, very nice amounts. You can pull up the PAPs online. We don't have much time. And then we want to feel younger and live longer, right? So Alpha CRS is the third product here, and it's super special because it has what is called a cellular longevity blend. I've underlined and highlighted here a few of the stuff that you see, you know, green tea, pomegranate, turmeric, grapeseed extract. Those are very popular as antioxidants. Then cellular energy blend, we're going to look at that really quick, what that means, but coenzyme Q10, ginkgo, quercetin, and a bit of tummy tamer as well. So what is causing the energy in our cells, the ATP, is the mitochondria in our cells. And as we age, we have less amount of mitochondria and they're less efficient, and you're producing lots of exhaust from them. So in Alpha CRS, it helps the mitochondria be healthy and effective. Just going quickly. It doesn't have any kind of stimulants, so it's pure energy, quitting the oxidation and the inflammation. And these, oops, I have one bottle missing. Okay. PBSs and the enzymes, I really like them because probiotics are super important for our gut health. TerraZyme was out there before. And then Mito2Max if you need some more energy, bone nutrient for everybody who needs better bones, do take a look at those. And what I wanted to point out here is that if you, as I said before, if you were to get all of these bottles separate, it would be like $300 and you would not be getting the results. If you buy them separate, it would be $146. And if you could get the package, it's $80, 80 euros, 65 PB plus taxes. And there's a warranty as well. If you don't like the results you see in 30 days, you can get your money back. But as they said, nobody ever needs to use that. I think my next slide is a little video from convention because I really want, it's 3.5 minutes, but I really want you to listen to Dr. Hill. He is an amazing person, and he was explaining how to put all this all together because we talk about, you need so many oils, you need supplements, you need all this stuff. Well, how do you do it?
So he,
this is what we're going to do every single day.
So this is what we do.
Every day I'm going to use Life on Vitality, I'm going to use the Terrazyme, and I'm going to use the PBSS. When I exercise, and I am going to start exercising, and if I do that, I'm going to use an oil like Deep Blue to help me be able to do that with greater ease. Rest and stress, we determined, we said, was not just about getting the proper amount of sleep, although we have the Serenity lineup for you that will help you to accomplish that very efficiently, but balance is the essential oil that you need to use every day. And then, of course, we talked about citrus, frankincense, and On Guard. Now, I know my time is limited, so bear with me for just one more moment. Nobody ever knows how to do it, so here's what you're going to do every single day, okay? We're going to get up in the morning. We're going to get up in the morning and you're going to put 2 to 3 drops on the bottom of your feet with balanced essential oil. You're going to put a couple of drops of frankincense under your tongue or put it in your water or take it in a capsule. You can put it on the bottom of your feet, but use frankincense every single morning. Take 1 PB Assist with breakfast and then Lifelong Vitality and Terrazyme with your morning meal. Afternoon. We're going to diffuse our favorite essential oil for mood management. For helping the body to be at rest during the day, I'm going to diffuse whatever oil it is that I would like. I'm going to again take Life on Vitality and Terrazyme with my afternoon meal, and then I'm going to use citrus oil in my water throughout the day, or take citrus oil in a capsule if you would like to, but gain exposure of citrus oil throughout the day. In the evening, when I come home, I'm going to take Life on Vitality and Terrazyme again. And I'm going to diffuse On Guard or take a capsule if I feel like I need that sustainability and some type of an immune capability for the body. Now let me make a point here as I go to this last slide, which is at bedtime. Diffuse your favorite oil for relaxation. Use the Serenity Soft Gel 30 minutes before sleep. And then apply Serenity or Cedarwood, if you like, to the bottom of your feet for a complete, full, and restful night's sleep. Sleep is when the body repairs itself. It's important that you have good sleep. It could not be any simpler to use the essential oils in that capacity. If you do nothing else from this conference, from this convention, take away that piece of information. If you're struggling with the use of the essential oils, I'm going to tell you it's most likely because you don't have consistency and a framework or a foundation to work from. Now, sometimes people say, Dr. Hill, that's just too much. I cannot do that. I'm sorry. Because the alternative is not a good one. And like it or not, we're all going to be limited to our own biological terrain. Laura will love that comment. We're all going to be limited to our own biological terrain, which means we must do things every single day. And yes, while it's hard to sit down at an afternoon meal and get out your pills, and I got to take Lifelong Vitality, and I got to take Terrazyme because Dr. Hill told me to, trust me, it's much better than the alternative, which is pulling out a handful of other pills.
I really liked hearing that at the mission, and I thought it was a wonderful recording. So I want to share that because knowing how to use holy oils regularly is super important. And yes, when I speak with people, and I have done that as a health coach, and I suggest they take a bunch of supplements, that's a big complaint. Oh, but that's a lot of pills. You mean I have to take 6 pills for my breakfast plus a Terrazyme plus that? That's 8 pills? I'm not sick. I don't want to take so many pills. Well, if you are taking the proper nutrition your body needs, you're not going to get sick, at least not that much. And as I read somewhere, it applies to exercise and it applies to nutrition. Either you spend your time and you make an effort to stay healthy and start doing that now that you are healthy, if you are. And if you're not quite healthy, then so much more work on that. Or else you're going to have to spend the time later being sick. And we all want to, as doTERRA has said, look, feel, and live younger, longer. And we are a bit of freaks in my family, and my husband insisted that in light of this, I should wish you Live long and prosper.
Thank you.